Hi everyone, in this video, you'll learn how to use the Wave extension as a developer. I'll demo how to use Wave to check for accessibility issues after making a change to a website's template. This is important because learning to use Wave in your own process means you're able to contribute to making your website more accessible. Let's get started. You can use Wave in a local, sandbox, or live environment. In this demo, we're going to pretend I just updated the website template and homepage for the Institute of Museum and Library Services. So we'll focus on template-related accessibility results, but also results that could be in the custom code for the homepage. To use Wave, you'll first need to install it. Check out the links below for the install link and other resources. Once Wave is installed, select the Wave extension icon and go to the Details tab. On the Details tab, we're going to review each section. So that includes errors, contrast errors, alerts, features, structural elements, and ARIA. There are 5 errors and each can be fixed by the developer. The first is a missing alternative text for a decorative image that just needs an empty alt attribute. The next 2 errors are label issues, which need to be investigated. To investigate, select the icon to go to where it is on the page, then select the icon on the page. From here, select Code to review the HTML code. If there are questions, select Reference to review how to fix the issue. The next error is an empty button for the search button, which needs a value attribute. The last error is an empty link for a scroll button. This could be fixed with screen reader only text that is hidden from visual users. Contrast errors can be investigated and fixed, or depending on your team, it might be something you talk about with a designer. Let's review the alerts. There is a select missing label and a field set missing legend alert that are developer focused. The select missing label and one of the field set missing legend alerts are for this fiscal year 2021 select menu. If you aren't sure what the issue is or how to fix it, you can select the information icon next to the result. For example, for this select menu, the default option needs to present the purpose instead of the first option. So it could say select fiscal year for impact data instead of fiscal year 2021. The redundant link alerts are grayed out. If there's ever a grayed out result, it means it's not visible on the page. You can turn off the CSS styles so you can access all the results on the page. The very small text alerts could either be fixed or, again, you might need to talk to a designer depending on your team's responsibilities. The last alert is redundant title text in the navigation menu. The titles are the same as the text, so they can probably just be removed. We've gone through the errors and alerts. Now, the feature, structure, and ARIA need to be reviewed. There are 2 developer-specific features that a developer might focus on, which are the form labels and the page's language. Depending on your responsibilities though, you might review more than just these. After reviewing those, it's time to look at the page's landmarks. I'm going to go to the Structure tab for this. Here, you just want to make sure your page's landmark regions are appearing correctly. Lastly, I'll go back to the Details tab and scroll down to the ARIA results. Each ARIA instance should be reviewed to make sure it's used correctly. The reference and code tools can be really helpful here. After you review your website's template once, you'll get familiar with the results that you've already gone over and can just focus on the new ones. You're ready to use Wave as part of your code publishing process.